Tom Sullivan, author of If You Could See What I Hear, has to trust his life to his service dog.
And with guide dogs, you really realize if you're working with a guide dog and you walk up to a street crossing and you listen for traffic. I've had situations where the dog is making a clear decision that says, hey, pal, don't cross that street. You know, the light hasn't changed. Or there's a cab coming around the corner. And you learn, never question the dog. The dog, the decisions the dog makes have to rule the question of how you work. It's really remarkable.
There just is an enormous amount of trust involved in that relationship, isn't there?
Yeah, and it's built slowly. You know, think about this, Fred. When the dog is born, you know, it's born in a litter, and it is sent out to a puppy raiser. And from the time the dog is 6 weeks old to the time the dog is probably 9 months, my goodness, the dog lives with a family, and the family pours its heart and soul into the animal. You know, the dog goes everywhere, church, the dog goes to the office, the dog goes to school with the kids, because the dog wears a bib that says, you know, guide dog in training. At 9 months, the family takes a drive, and on a Sunday afternoon, turns the dog over to somebody that puts it in a kennel, and the family's gone. Now, the next day, another guy shows up. This is trainer, right? An old trainer shows up, and for the next 4 months, maybe 5 months, this trainer floods this dog with attention, loves the dog, engages the dog, you know, develops self-worth for the dog, trains the dog. Because when you think about all the things that guide dogs have to learn, you know, they have to learn about street crossings and how to watch traffic flow. They have to be able to walk up to a curb and line your toes up so that you don't step over the edge.